let's start soil. Soil that the one of the abiotic factor we can say here, the soil is also playing a vital role. That means simply we can say that soil depends upon based upon the soil only producers are present. That means plant photosynthetic activity and plant growth is depends upon the based on the soil only. So that means indirectly we can say here, if plants are more, their herbivores will be more. If herbivores are more, carnivores will be more. That means if the soil if such kind of soil is present, there is no growth of plant. Automatically, that affects on the remaining other also, isn't it or not? That affects the remaining organisms like herbivores, like carnivores. In all tropic levels, they can't survive. So that means we can say soil is going to play a key role. The nature and properties of the soil in different places vary depending on the climate and weathering process involved. Depending on the climate and weathering process involved. What is weathering? Weathering is a particular process which we can say that a particular term for the process by which rock at or near the earth surface is going to be disintegrated and decomposed by the action of wind or water. We can say if a particular rock is containing minerals, a particular rock is there in one particular place. So this particular rock which is there, due to the air, due to the water, slowly is going to dissolve over. The dissolution of this particular rock by weather or by water, it may be. So it will take time, thousands and millions of years of time it may take over. So that we can say weathering. So weathering makes over surrounding area is going to be rich with minerals. That means soil is going to become rich with minerals, we can say. So depends upon the soil of different places, climate and weathering process, how faster the weathering is growing, that also the nature and properties of the soil in different places vary depending on the climate and weathering process which involved here. Next, the characteristics of the soil, which is very, very important. A small area, but we are getting questions here. A small area it is going to be, but we are going to get questions here. The various characteristics of the soil, such as soil composition, grain size, that means soil granules, grain size, then aggregation. The grain size and aggregation only determine the percolation and water holding capacity. Means, for example, if the soil grain size is this much, that simply I'm talking about a desert, the sand like, okay. So can they hold the water? No, they can't hold the water. If they can't hold the water, there is no growth of producers. In that way, we can say the grain size and aggregation of the soil determine the percolation and water holding capacity of the soil. And water holding capacity directly makes the growth of plants. If they can hold, that means very minute the particles of soil is there and they can hold the water. That means a plant can grow there. So that means soil is playing a vital role here. And pH of the soil, very, very important. pH also very important for the growth of plants. Mineral composition and pH determine to large extent the vegetation in any area, which it determines what type of animals to be supported. A type of plants and followed by what type of animals. Okay, so that what we can say here, the various characteristics of the soil, such as soil composition, grain size, and aggregation determine the percolation and water holding capacity. And the characteristics along with these parameters, such as pH and mineral composition, pH and mineral composition determine to a large extent the vegetation in any area. In turn, it dictates the types of animals that can be supported. Similarly, when it comes to the aquatic environment, that we can say on the surface till one particular end, that means till bottom, what you can see, the water only. So that means if you want to see the soil composition, you should come at the bottom of the water. So at the bottom, we call it as benthic condition. Benthic, we can say it as. The bottom of the water can be called benthic. So when it comes to the aquatic environment, the sediment characteristics often determine the type of benthic animals that can live there. They determine the type of benthic animal which can live there. Okay, so that's it. This is about soil. And moving on to the pressure. When it comes to the pressure, pressure is also another factor that changes the dramatically with depth in the ocean. That means, let's take a look on the pressure changes here. For every 10 meters in the marine water, in the deep sea, when you are going, one atmospheric pressure is going to increase. So that means if you go 100 meters in the marine water, what we can say? 100 meters in the marine water, what is the atmospheric pressure? What is the pressure in the marine water? So first of all, let us see what is the atmospheric pressure. Means atmospheric pressure, we use it to say one atmosphere, which we are living, that place where they are living in atmosphere, pressure is going to be one atmosphere, or you can term it as 760 mm of Hg. Okay, now you are going, this is a deep sea. In the deep sea, when you are going 10 meters, one plus one, that means one already there, then plus one, two, then like this, one more. So likewise, when you go to 1 kilometer down, you imagine how much it is going to be. How much it is going to be? Can you able to calculate? For every 10 meters, one atmosphere pressure. 1 kilometer down to the bottom of the sea. Can you imagine? 1 kilometer, that means 1,000 meters, isn't it? That means that for every 10 meters, one atmosphere. That means here, 100 into 10. That means you have to remember it as 100 atmosphere. 100 plus this one. 101 atmospheric pressure. Simply for your understanding, I am saying, the atmosphere which you are facing is now one. Okay, then when you go into the deep sea, nearly 1 kilometer range, so compare with our atmospheric pressure, it is going to be 100 times more. At that particular condition, our body won't be able to tolerate that pressure even. That our body will blast out when we go into the deep sea. That means I can put an oxygen cylinder, I can go anywhere. You can't say like that. Why? Because pressure is going to be huge when you go more and more. That means 1 kilometer, when you go down, it will be maximum 100 times than our pressure. That's why that the whatever the technology which people apply to go for the space, the similar kind of technology is also required to go into the bottom of the sea. Not so easy that a special training can be seen over. Going into the deep water. Okay, that's the issue. Let's talk about in order here that what we said at sea level, that particular land, on land, we say one atmosphere pressure is present. Organisms of land less than one atmosphere at sea level. Assertion. We have a question here that means that you can understand. Marine organisms under much more pressure than those on land. How can we say? Water is much heavier than air. That is the reason which marine organisms are under much more pressure than those on land. And the pressure in water increase one atmosphere per 10 meter depth. We need more adaptation for aquatic organism, which we need more adaptations for aquatic organism. Okay, so this is the condition. And now let us see an interesting issue here. Rohtang Pass near Manali. Do you know that Kullu and Manali?
Yes, sir.
That is in more height, 3,500 meters, the height which to the regular land surface, which we are talking about, 3,500 meters height. We are now going, I'm taking you there. The Manas Sarovar, Tibet, that is also, we can say Everest, anything. Any mountain ranges we are talking about, any mountain ranges, when we go there, the pressure is going to be decreased. When we go there, pressure is going to be decreased. Let us see how. How will it decrease? For example, one atmosphere pressure, which I said to you, one atmosphere pressure. Listen carefully, very interesting item. 1 atmosphere pressure. 1 atmosphere pressure means how much we said? 760 mm of Hg. So what is the oxygen partial pressure in them? How do we calculate the oxygen partial pressure? Let's go to the whiteboard and we'll make it out. We'll make this possible. Let's go there. So for 760 mm of Hg, for 100% gases which are there in the air, what is the pressure? 760 mm of Hg. What is the oxygen percentage in atmosphere? Is there anyone? What is the oxygen percentage in the atmosphere?
21%.
Very good. 21%. For 100% gases, atmospheric pressure is 760 mm of Hg. 21% oxygen, how much? So how should we calculate 21 by 100 into 760 mm of Hg? Okay, so how much it will come? 159 mm of Hg. So what is the oxygen partial pressure in atmosphere? When it is asked over, you can say directly. What is oxygen partial pressure? 159 mm of Hg. Okay, so when we breathe, this 159 mm of Hg, oxygen partial pressure, when it reaches to our lungs, it will reduce up to 104 mm of Hg with various reasons that we'll discuss in the human physiology. 104 mm of Hg. So actually, why this pressure is required for us? In some certain pressure only, our hemoglobin can bind with oxygen to form oxyhemoglobin. Then do you know every hemoglobin can carry 4 oxygen molecules? Every hemoglobin molecule in human being can carry 4 oxygen molecules. Okay, now listen carefully that we one hemoglobin can carry 4 oxygen molecule. At what pressure? 95 mm of Hg is enough for us. 95 mm of Hg. We said in atmosphere 159. When we breathe 104. At least no need to remember all this calculation, but just for general idea. Now I'm moving on to the next page. Now finally we got that 9500 mm of Hg oxygen partial pressure required for 100% oxygen binding. That means we said one hemoglobin can carry 4 oxygen molecule. Our life will go smoothly in this particular pressure. Now let's go to the Rohtang Pass. That in that area, that 3,500 meters above height, atmospheric pressure is going to be comparatively less. For your understanding, I'm making almost half, 3,500 meter area. So here, whatever the calculations I said, 159 mm of Hg oxygen partial pressure, all that on land, on the surface. But when you go up, let us see what happened. When we go up, almost 760, we said, almost 380. For your easy understanding, atmospheric pressure is reduced. Here, how much? 760. For 760 mm of Hg, what is the oxygen partial pressure? Nearly 160. So now half it reduced. Again, oxygen is same. Percentage of oxygen will be same. But we cannot expect that 159 there, less than nearly 80 mm of Hg. Okay, so all these are looking like a confusing calculation, but at least you need to understand here, oxygen partial pressure comparatively when you are going up, when you are going for a mountain range, is going to be decreased. Okay, it is going up, when going to be decreased. Minimum we require 95 to 100 mm of Hg oxygen partial pressure, but now you see how much it is. So instead of 4 molecule, hemoglobin can bind with only 2 oxygen molecule. When you are going mountain ranges, when you are going up, climbing a hill, you are going. So when you are going, your oxygen carrying capacity to the body is going to be reduced because of low pressure of oxygen. So I hope you understand what I am saying. Oxygen partial pressure is reduced. Okay, now let's go back. So what happens when oxygen partial pressure is reduced? When you are going to the mountain hill range, what happened? That we have to see. Altitude sickness, we can see. That means simply you understand instead of full supply that you are getting half supply oxygen supply to your body. That's why we feel vomiting sensation, fatigue, tiredness, less oxygen supply, heart palpitation, abnormality in the heartbeat, these kind of things. If anybody went to this particular Kulu and Manali, the tour, you might have faced this condition when you are going for walking to the hill range. You might have faced this particular, but I myself faced this condition, nausea, vomiting sensation, fatigue, tiredness, heart palpitation, abnormality. Reason why? Low oxygen partial pressure. Now I'm not going with calculation. With calculations I said over, but to remember, low oxygen partial pressure, hemoglobin can't bind with adequate number of oxygen. Instead of 4, it may bind with only 2 oxygen molecules. That is reason I wrote here. Low atmospheric pressure does not get enough oxygen. That only I explained now for you. That only I explained. Okay. So what is the solution? Take rest. That is the only solution because we are tourists. But now we get a doubt here. Okay, we are tourists. Okay. But already in that place, some people are living, isn't it? Already on that particular mountain hill ranges, some people are living in that area. They settled down. Okay, so every time when I say mountain, that means I'm drawing like this. You can see a bigger place, that is, the road will be like this. As I see in this particular road will be like this. We can go up, you can go up. So like this, you can go. So the people who are settled down in that particular area, what about those people who are settled down in that area? They have only half supply of oxygen. Is there any solution? Yes, there is a solution for them. Those who are settled down, the people who are living there, the solution is going to be polycythemia is the solution. Heard about this before? Polycythemia? Polycythemia is the solution. Heard about this word before? I am asking you.
No, sir.
No? Are you sure? Polycythemia, leukocythemia, thrombocythemia. No? Increase in the number of RBC we call polycythemia in the structural organization chapter. Increase. That is a disease actually. Increase in the number of RBC is we can call it as polycythemia. Did you remember? So that increase in the number of RBC, that is a disease actually. But for the people who are settled down there, increase in the number of RBC, that when we go there, what happens? We breathe faster. We'll try to take more oxygen into the body. But people already settled down there for a long period of time, what they do? So that means their body will adjust over for that increase in the number of RBC. Okay, so a disease in our area, which is a common phenomena, the people who are living in that area. That was the interesting thing. Polycythemia is not a disorder in Rohtang Pass, in Manali, that Kulu Manali. Manali is a mountain range actually, or in a Manas Sarovar of Everest, we can see. In Tibet it is. Okay, so that's it. That is about that. Let's take a look again. The pressure, we said another factor that changes dramatically with depth in the ocean. When we go to the organism and land, face less than 1 atmosphere, means place where we are living. But at the sea level, that when you go to the sea, much water is much heavier than air. Marine organisms are under much more pressure than those on land. But we said the pressure in water increases at the rate of 1 atmosphere per 10 meter depth. Organisms living in such extreme environment show a wide range of biochemical adaptation. Some organisms possess adaptations that are physiological and allow them to respond quickly to a stressful situation. But if you had ever been to any high altitude place like Rohtang Pass, 3,500 meter long, that height, or we can say that Manas Sarovar of Tibet, So what happens there that we face altitude sickness, like when we go there as a tourist, altitude sickness like nausea, vomiting sense, fatigue, tiredness, heart palpitations will come, abnormality in the heartbeat. Likewise, we may expect over. But what about the people who settle down there? Why it is happening? That means we can say now, low atmospheric pressure of high altitude, the body does not get enough oxygen, but you gradually get acclimatized and overcome the altitude sickness. Then how did this problem is solved? The body compensates the low oxygen availability by increasing the red blood cell production, by increasing the red blood cell production by polycythemia. Okay, that is the people who settle down for a longer period of time who are staying and increasing the breath rate, all that you can see. So the binding capacity of hemoglobin is reduced over. That's why we increased the number of RBC. So this is all about the pressure and pressure related issues here. We get different kinds of questions from this area. I hope I explained all the concepts related to the pressure. So this is the story of soil and pressure.